All right, stream's up. Just don't say any no-no words. Don't say any gamer words.
I can't believe you think so lowly of me.
Let me plug this in all the spots. Okay, cool. So, not too many people in here right now, but I'm here with gfelt, probably the best Narancia player. Cool guy. Pretty knowledgeable about how the game works in general.
Flattered.
Cool. Awesome. I haven't looked at these changes yet, but we're gonna go through it. It seems like there's a lot. It seems like there's a lot.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So, do you see what I'm looking at?
Yeah, I see.
Cool. So, these first changes, I guess we're going to go through the system changes. Throw through scale has been standardized. This means that there's no longer character specific frame advantage differentials, right?
I didn't even know this existed, honestly.
Yeah, like Brando had more advantage when his throw was tagged compared to other characters.
That's pretty crazy.
Some had more, some had less. Like when you teched with Giorno and Requiem, he had additional frame advantage.
Very cool game.
Yeah, that's like it's like another Kuso type beat that is kind of good to get removed. First time chat,
at least they're like aware of this stuff and are trying to actively get rid of it.
That's good, because they're even that's though I really sign. Like this game, there's still a lot of stuff in it that's really stupid, and if like the general FGC saw it, they would be like, oh, this game sucks, you know what I mean?
Yeah, for sure.
When a throw is made on the same frame and throw escape occurs, one piece side was ready to move first. Okay, that just seems like more stupidness that they needed to get rid of. Landing. Timing at which technique cannot be activated with a one frame reversal on landing. Okay, so this means that if you get air reset, you have options now, right? Yeah, this is huge.
This is kind of a big change, because it means that if you peck from an air, like a knockdown, you can maybe SG now from the tech, which is kind of huge.
This isn't about soft knockdown though, right? This is about air resets like Risotto, like what he does.
Yeah.
After launching a back jump attack, attackers attack midair, landing receive. What does that mean? I haven't noticed that.
I have no idea either.
Okay. Bound hit. Position of hurt attack for each character was significantly different, but this difference. Does this refer to like real back when a character gets hit?
Some of the wording in these patch notes are so like obtuse. I have no clue what this could be.
Makoto, do you have the Japanese notes? I can look at those too. Oh, I didn't post this on Twitter. Going over patch notes with gfelt. Cool. Awesome. So let's open up another tab here. Oh, what the fuck is this? This isn't the same format at all. So we're looking at whoever just joined, please leave.
Okay.
Like I'm streaming. Can you leave? Thanks. Cool. Said bound hit. And we're looking at it right here. Bound your character go to no yarum kite. Okay, this does refer to real back, and that's something that I've noticed on a few characters. I don't remember which ones offhand, But I noticed it especially a lot doing gyro grounded combos because his stuff doesn't move forward like at all, and he has really small like his buttons are small and they don't move forward, so a lot of his stuff will like drop on some characters. Stand rush.
That's a pretty sweet change then.
Yeah. Reel back differentials is something that was really big in Street Fighter 4. Like when you were when you would combo certain characters, it would just drop because their collision box was way too far back. Wake up characters. Okay, have you noticed this? This is a big fucking deal. Characters had different wake up timings. Yeah.
This is just another one of those changes. Like, it's.
It was really random. It didn't need to be in the game.
The Kuso.
Yeah, that's great. Fantastic. I love to see it. These characters, Ice, Giorno, and Gachio, they woke up a little bit slower. So if you had frame kills to melee somebody, sometimes, depending on what it was, they wouldn't work on these characters. Hermes still has the stickers to, like, delay her wake up. Whoever joined, leave, please. But yeah, it wouldn't work. That's a good thing. Fish so close dash against getting up opponent doesn't cause the opponent to slip through the backside. Good. More Kuso, that is gone.
I don't think I've ever seen that happen.
It happens with Koichi a lot.
Probably a small character thing.
Chain, so if the middle attack and lower attack are stacked on top of each other, high low unblockables no longer exist.
Whammu coin is going.
I know, it's so sad. This stuff
the Pet Shop Foundation has collapsed.
It's horrible. That was the whole point of that character. You could get 50% for free if you did Whammu Pet Shop and you just did some cheap ass unblockables with it.
You just like rug pulled the entire server with your Whammu coin.
That's so stupid. I was doing it as a joke.
You personally did this.
That character sucks. He doesn't do much, you know? He's just a footsies character with no anti-airs. What's the point? But
now he's got no sauce.
Fixed a problem where continuous guard. Okay, so they removed cheat block. For those that don't know, if you were in block stun and somebody was doing like a high-low mix-up, as long as you didn't exit block stun, you could hold down and block it all. This change means that Dio can still do his high-low, but other characters who could use assists like Pet Shop or Gappy or Koichi to do high-lows or Foo Fighters doesn't exist anymore. Poor Wendy.
Yeah, they got rid of the whole cheat blocking thing, but they just kind of made it so you block the unblockables automatically.
Characters now have real high-lows, like, that don't leave block stun because cheat block is gone, but unblockable is cool. Taunt animation. I saw this in chat that...
Yeah, this is huge.
Yeah, that the long taunt lines don't exist. I always thought that was really stupid because every character should have it or nobody should have it. It also very just looks so really dumb because you're doing this long taunt that just breaks the pace of the game. Mm-hmm. Taunt.
That's funny, but it's definitely better that it's not the game.
I agree. I guess we're moving on to character specifics. I was really hoping Jonathan would get something because I think that character is like doo-doo fart. Like the sound effect that plays in Camp Lazlo when like Lupus gets shit on or something. Like that tier of doo-doo fart.
He's too milquetoast.
He doesn't do anything. He has good buttons for playing footsies, but Jonathan can't open you up, and he has no Oki, he doesn't have pressure, he doesn't really have anything except damage, but there's too many characters that do a lot of damage for that to be a thing.
I think young Joseph is a kind of, like, footsie-esque character that kind of fits the same build, but just a lot better.
Right. So Will Zeppeli, it looks like Hamon breathing. His and Lisa's Hamon breathing had longer recovery than the others.
Yeah, this really annoyed me when I played this character. Like, his recovery was really long for some reason.
Now,
but, like,
those two also had, they generated meter faster than the other Hotmon characters, too. You could go from 0 to 3 bars with Lisa, Lisa, and Will in 13 seconds, and the other Hotmon characters took 20 seconds. So,
and they made it even faster.
Now. Yeah, I wonder how fast it is, because you could already use that as like an anti-zoning tool. Having that as a tool on any of those characters means that people have to approach you if you have a life lead. They already did, but there's even more emphasis to punish them playing passively.
Right.
Overdrive.
This next change sounds really cool.
It's very interesting. Let me read it real quick. I haven't seen it. Adjustment of attack startup. I don't know if that's faster or slower. Attack does more damage. That seems unnecessary because it already did a lot of damage. Increase amount of blow off. That,
I think this is a weird translation thing. I think it either means knock back or knock up.
Let's
I don't really know.
Take a look. It means knockback. So blow off in all of these notes going forward is going to refer to knockback. I think that's fine, but I don't know how much it is, because one of the things that you could do with Will is if you ended your combo with overdrive, it you have a tech chase scenario though, where if they tech and you jump at them, you get a high low 50-50 if they choose to block, and they can't really do much because you can't SG there. Adjustments have been made to suit the intended use. Light overdrive now generates a series of hits from a ground hit. I don't know what that means. Could be anything. Middle standing mid attack that continuously hits after a ground hit. I don't know what that means either.
But the heavies where the sauce is.
Yeah, the special attack zoom punch will cause a series of hits after a grounded hit. Instead of limiting the circumstance in which the hit is confirmed, the heavy skill has been adjusted to have a performance of a follow-up attack without consuming the HH gauge. Does that mean that you can combo with zoom punch after overdrive, or what?
I think it means it automatically does a zoom punch so that you can get a crumple count or crumple combo after it, similar to EX, except you don't.
That's
have to
ridiculous. He didn't need.
I think that's what that means.
I hope that that's what that means. That sounds cool. And it makes me wonder if the zoom punch is special cancelable itself. I doubt it will be, because maybe it's part of the move. Who knows? We'll see. EX overdrive, binding time. Why did he need that? You didn't need to give.
He could do even more shit now.
He already could do whatever he wanted. He could dash up and do TK cutters. He could neutral jump and do like jump H dive kick. I don't know why he needed that, but you know.
They felt bad
cool.
After accidentally nerfing him in the ass patch.
Hotmon cutter, combo count fixed, same move. I skimmed the notes and I saw this.
Yeah, there's a lot of these.
A lot of this.
It's like they're normalizing just like grounded and air special moves to use the same IPS.
I don't know how I feel about that. I would have to think about all the characters and what you do with that. But you're very rarely using more than two Hotmon cutters in a combo with Will to begin with.
Yeah, I think for most characters, this isn't going to ever come up. It's just, they're just normalizing it for everybody, I think.
Okay, yeah, I saw it on like every character skimming through it. Brando, Vaporizing Freeze, that's the medium follow-up to Rekka. Where only attack behavior was executed instead of backwards movement. I haven't seen that happen before, but that's cool. It got fixed. Combo count, if same move hits 3 or more times. I feel like there wasn't circumstances where you could do that and have it be good. You know what I mean? Because if you do, you can't freeze once and then freeze again for another launch, right?
Yeah, it's a weird change for sure.
You must have broken 5 or 6 ribs. That's the light follow-up to Qua. To leave a large distance when it's guarded. It's safe, I think. That's what that means.
Making this more safe.
That's kind of good. Brando needed something, and that's interesting that they went that way. That's the overhead that you use Iggy to combo off. Sped down startup, increased damage. Damage reaction. Adjustment made use 2 derivative techniques differently on hit and guard to gain a better advantage. What does that mean?
Before this hard knockdown, and they're saying change the opponent's reaction with it succeed, so maybe you can combo after this now?
That'd be cool.
Possibly. So, like, they're buffing his Rekka stuff, so the light now is safer, and the heavy might give you a combo starter now?
Yeah, without Iggy, right? Because you had to use Iggy to get anything off of that. That's cool. He kind of needed more freedom in his combos. Like, he was pretty much tied to Iggy. Young Joseph, increased gaps when... Adjustments were made to increase the gap when swinging and slightly lower the performance when standing still. What the fuck does that mean?
I'm assuming that just means you can't mash it as much. Like, it's not going to come out as fast if you do consecutive 2Ls.
All it says in Japanese is increased gaps. I don't know what that means in FGC dev translation, so I really don't know. Backdash extended recovery. That seems unnecessary because... having the back run for the characters that do have it is a pretty big deal because it makes backward movement less committal. I don't know. Japan thinks this character is like on the same tier as Risotto, which I personally don't see.
And I think that's one reason why they're nerfing this character. I think they just listened to Japan more, which is kind of typical, I guess.
EX Clacker Volley now does more damage. Weird. That's like a nothing change. Command, I'll smash you good. What is that? Is that the overhead with clackers?
That's the overhead, I'm pretty sure. I think. Hold on.
If HH gauge is consumed, it's possible to follow up with rebuff overdrive and go for a combo after. Clacker overhead. That move was bad. That move, like, I never saw that from anything. And as far as I've labbed that character, it's not particularly useful, except on some really tall characters like Wamu and the horses. But you can combo after that. That's cool. Clacker boomerang, increased gaps.
This one is, like, if this means what I think it could mean, this could be pretty terrible for the character. It might mean that the EX boomerang doesn't come back anymore.
That's what it looks like.
Yeah, that's what it sounds like.
That is horrible. Why would they do that? That's like the coolest part of that character.
For real.
Caesar, bubble launcher, that same change that everybody used, but this was already a thing for Caesar. You couldn't use more than 2 2-3-6 L's in a combo, whether it was air or grounded. I guess they just stuck this on, like, every character. I'm not sure. Bubble lenses, same change. You couldn't do that either. Lisa, what move is getaway? Is that her DP? Or no, wait, that's 3H. Yeah, that's 3H.
No, getaway is her DP. They just straight up nerfed her DP.
What? How is this a nerf?
Like the bottom two curve. It has less of a hitbox now. It's less active.
This says hurtbox. It stayed on the ground after you went up.
Oh, hurtbox.
Yeah. So this looks like it implies before that you could do grounded punishes on Lisa's DP. And now you can, which, you know.
Okay, that's good then.
Visual clarity, it seems fine. And this is just like Will's, where her homo breathing is better. I didn't see them do that on Caesar, but they made the two characters that already had faster homo breathing do it faster. Mm-hmm. Which is cool. It was already significant before, but awesome that they got something. Cars 3H, I think that's what it is. Command acceptance times have been adjusted. Does that mean you have wider cancel windows?
Yeah, I think that's what that means.
Shatter against the wall. What's that move? 214L? 214X?
It's the one where he just kicks you across the stage.
Oh, okay. I never saw Cars doing that more than twice in a combo anyway. Mm. And this is Ulf. I've never seen anybody use Ulf in this game, to be honest with you. So I really don't know whether that was a thing before. Wamu got literally nothing. What a shame. Wamu coin. It was a pump and dump all along. Ponzi scheme. ACDC, to hell with you. I don't know which mood that is.
This is the 623.
Oh, okay.
The DP input, like where he
does the veins up, right?
Yeah. And then the mode version they changed. This move is super obnoxious. It sounds like they just made the hitbox bigger and make it.
That's fine.
Like, harder to punish.
Because last patch, they wanted to, like, they made it better for him to play at, like, mid-range. Because they made his anti-airs better. And they, like, made his conversions better, right?
Yeah.
Burning King, Wheel of Pain.
Pretty cool buff.
That's the one where you can do the same side or overhead or cross-up.
Yeah, this is the mixy guessy move.
The knowledge check move that takes people to top 12. I get it.
I got hit by that move so many times.
There's tricks to that, and I'll tell you how to do it later, but moving on. Simmer like stew. I don't know what move that is either. That's the follow-up to the veins.
Wait, yeah, that's the Yeah, that's the follow-up cutscene thing.
The derivative techniques can no longer be launched when the opponent is forced to go into down state after exceeding these same limit. I don't know what that implies.
Yeah. Have you seen those Wamu, or not Wamu, the SCDC combos where, like, the combo counter resets, but they keep comboing after it?
Oh, yeah, I've seen that.
I think that's what this is fixing.
Cool. That looked really stupid and unintentional anyway.
Yeah.
Gunblaze, I'm reading what you're saying. And yeah, this refers to the follow-up only on the 623X. Emerald Splash, I'm disappointed that this is the only change this character got. It's a
pretty sick fucking move.
Like, Japan doesn't think this character is that good, and that's what I'm seeing. He didn't get anything. Yeah. Max Sev is still gonna get carried to winning every tournament, and you know, that's just the life we gotta live. It's gonna be that way.
Hits. I remember you saying, like, months ago, we just gotta learn the matchup.
That was when your character was broken. And to be honest with you, I still think a lot of people could be playing the matchup better. Myself, too.
Yeah, the character just punishes you for playing, like, the smallest amount wrong.
A little bit, yeah. Three Emerald Splashes? I don't think I saw three Emerald Splashes in his combos anyway.
I don't think this is like an actual relevant thing either.
Oh, Jesus. Jesus Christ, what is all this? Okay.
I don't know anything about Iggy, but I know you messed with him a little bit, so this is all you.
Okay. GHA, only certain costumes are behaving differently. I didn't know that there was a difference between regular Iggy and ugly Iggy for this move.
Yeah, they have like a different cutscene animation.
I didn't know that.
Yeah, so apparently that was a thing.
Okay, dash, timing when dash jump becomes available, standardized. So Iggy, when he ran, he had to run for longer before he could dash jump at you, which sucks. It made his movement feel pretty bad. And this is gonna be pretty useful because Iggy does have already, like, last patch, have solid pressure from jump-ins. He's doing the same kinds of mix-ups that Dio and Brando are doing. But that's cool. Great change for him. Stand on standing heavy attack, increase forward distance. I saw this in Gyro too. I wonder if it's a change that they did for a lot of characters where combos are made more stable because you advance forward during the move. And this sounds like what that is for Iggy. So you a lot of the times, in order to get the half circle back stand rush rejump on Iggy, you had to press less buttons. You would have to do jump H, 6-6, jump H, and then you would only be able to do 2M, whatever that move is called, stand rush into rejump. This sounds like he's going to be able to get more damage in that combo.
It's pretty sweet.
Stand normal attack, crouch medium. Iggy's stand 2M is the anti-air looking move that doesn't actually have an anti-air hitbox. So this looks like they extended the hitbox probably upwards so it actually acts as an anti-air and made it faster. And the increased knockback on it, so...
in this game?
Yeah, so crazy. It looks like they gave Iggy an anti-air that he can combo off of, which is... that's pretty dope.
That sounds pretty huge, if that's a real thing.
So, stand, jump, medium. Iggy's stand, jump, medium is the wheels. That's not an overhead, it's just really fast and huge. And they made it faster. That's cool. Stand, JH is the two-hit overhead. And you do have to block them both overhead. Sped up the attack startup, corrected movement behavior. I don't know what the movement behavior might be. It already moves him pretty far forward, so I wonder if they got rid of that. Iggy's stand off jump H was made faster. I'm not sure what that implies. The fool that's Iggy's 236X in stand on, where he just, like, shoots the stand at you. Shorten the recovery, accelerated return, that means it comes out of it faster, increase attack's damage, change the damage reaction with weak and middle attack. I don't know what that means. It means that light and medium have a different use, but I don't know what the use is.
Yeah, a lot of these changes sound like you have to really actually see, try out the character to really know how much of a difference this makes.
Yeah. Old Joseph.
Old Joseph, though.
Yeah, he had a lot of shit too, right?
This is potentially, like, bottom five to bottom six territory. This is pretty much.
Oh, it's like that? It's not that much? Okay.
I don't actually know. I don't know how much.
Special attack.
It's hard to tell because these fucking patch notes are so hard to read.
2x4, I see you in the chat. What move is that changes everything?
That's his 3 and a standing low looking move.
Oh, okay. When Coltar is used, it is possible to use this move as a starting point for a follow up. Does that mean you can pick up off Coltar with 3H, 3M?
Maybe. It's really hard to tell what it means. It's either that you can combo into Coltar after or the other way around.
Okay. So Coltar, this move is like useless. It's not valid Oki. It's a very niche combo tool, but sped up behavior, made it faster, that's probably good. Changed damage reaction, they gave it more hits. I don't know what that's for.
I'm assuming it's the barrel hits, like when you...
Oh, okay, yeah, that makes sense. He got one, and there was like this cool combo that Hyenas found where you SG the oil, and it's pretty cool stuff. Reduce the survival time, I guess that means it's on the floor for like a shorter amount of time. And then they gave the tar a shorter hitbox. Since this is a move that hits yourself and has a significant impact on your scrambles. Okay, I kind of
so
get it.
You could put it like under the opponent easier and not accidentally step on it as much, I think.
That's cool.
Their intention.
Good change for that. And then this looks like you can actually combo off of it, which is good. It actually makes it useful. Hamon Overdrive is the overhead chop.
The overhead chop is not actually an overhead.
Yeah, I think it was in vanilla. Decrease recovery, I guess that makes it faster. Amount of blow off an opponent's hit, airborne and hit. I saw a lot of combos where you could like do a bunch of chops mid combo, but you needed assist to do it. Maybe this makes him less dependent on that. Solar Energy Hamon is the stand-on follow-up to like the sweep with Hermit Purple. Derivative thing is that another like it's the same thing as ACDC's where like the combo counter.
Yeah, I think
fucked
so.
Up.
Something like that.
Wait. What am I looking at here?
Cool Ice is such a non-character. They didn't even give him the correct header.
What's right in front of me?
That's the standoff move where it's like low overhead or.
Oh, that terrible ass move. Okay.
Yeah.
Moving on. Ice, standing heavy, fixed counter hit, but having the onset of the attack crushed. Don't know what that means.
This is funny. Have you seen that video of Ice getting hit by Mariah's super and he just gets TOD'd by it?
No.
I guess the bug was that if you get counter hit during his heavy, you just get counter hit for the entire combo.
Does that make it do more damage?
Yeah, it just makes him fucking melt instantly. He just got TOD'd by a single Mariah level 1.
Okay. Interesting. Once and for all. I don't know what move that is either, to be honest. Maybe I should look up a move list.
I think that's the stand on ball move? The cream thing? I think.
No idea. But Mariah, her knives. Again, I didn't see any combos where you do three knives. And then electricity, I guess that's wire. She got like general changes that these would. Actually, I think this one might be relevant because I feel like I've seen Wendy do three wires in a combo.
Yeah, that one might act. Yeah, I
think. Oh, yeah, yeah. I remember commenting on this once where he hit me with three wires in one combo and I was like, what the fuck? IPS doesn't work on this move?
Rest in peace, Mariah.
For real. I think it was part of her max damage that got shot. Which is unfortunate, but that character is decent.
He's been spending so much time on that character just for him to shoot his ass.
I mean, really, this isn't a big deal. Wendy found this thing recently where it's like a real high-low with Mariah that you don't even have to be in block stun to do. Like, he'll knock you down, and she has like the Prosciutto Bruno button where it'll hit you crouching if you do dash jump, right? Mariah's jump H also launches you like those buttons, so it's good stuff. That character's moving up in the world. All of this character's fucking moves are bird noises. I don't know what this is, but
caw caw. That's so such a good name.
There's that general change. Breakthrough beat you up is the 236 in standoff. And I think actually were combos where you would see Starwind do this more than once. Shigechi got a few things, but I don't know what the moves are. I don't know anything about this character, do you?
I have no clue. But they made his HHA do less damage, maybe? So they potentially nerfed this character 2 patches in a row.
Unfortunate. But I don't know anything about this character, so I'm just gonna skip it.
Me neither.
Jotaro 4, stand heavy, expand it inward. Okay, cool. Sounds like a quality of life change where it would like it won't drop the combo. And then this change. They changed Rohan's
those are the pins.
It wasn't half circle back before. Oh wait, yeah, it is pens. It is pens because okay, yeah, it's now quarter circle forward for pens. That's cool. I like that. Especially playing characters like Johnny where you have three moves that have overlapping inputs. It's really annoying.
Yeah, that shit is super annoying. They changed quite a few of those.
Ohiyasu Chew on this is 3H, I believe. The jump cancel one. Stance hit detection doesn't appear when onset is crushed. Okay, so this... the stand... hitbox doesn't go away. Okay, it's so your combos don't drop when you hit the stand, and then it goes away. I've seen that a few times.
Oh, okay.
Fixed a bug that caused a stand to execute an attack in the opposite direction. Never seen it, no idea, but that's cool. Apparently, Akira's burst was buggy. Have you ever seen that?
I've never seen anybody use this assist, so no.
Early on, I used to see Giorno players play Giorno Akira so they could get extra time in Requiem. Mm. User mode, normal attack, standing heavy attack. You advance the stand. I guess that makes it bigger. Koichi. I talk to Kala a lot. And I feel like Koichi is, like, potentially pretty high tier. Well, not even potentially, I just think Koichi is a high tier character. And giving that character more than he already had would make him too fucking dangerous, you know?
Mm-hmm. He definitely has the tools to be, like, a super scary character.
Freeze is insanity. How long it lasts and that Koichi can get it off of throw is nuts.
Yeah, the character just has like so much, like, it just shuts you down so hard once the pressure gets going.
And he's got some decent neutral too. People say that he's small and think his neutral's bad, but like,
yeah,
Boing is nuts. Boing is super good. Yeah, stand mode, normal attack, stand medium, extended reach, gave it more hits, gave it more damage, cool. Crouching heavy, it's more active, damage reaction, they gave it more knockback, that's cool. I guess that makes it easier to combo with. Jump heavy, I don't know why they buffed this because this was already a really good button. Like, it's a bad yacht button, and all of those are, like, good on every character they're on. Duration of hitbox, it's more active, increased damage. I don't know why. Didn't really need it. And then jump medium is, like, the... it's, like, the horizontal poke that he does with Act 1, I think. Increased hits, increased damage, cool. He didn't really get that much. I saw people in chat, like, being like, what, Koichi buffs? But this is really small stuff.
Yeah, it's just some, like, quality of life stuff.
You've been playing this character a bunch. I don't know anything about him.
I mean, playing the character is a bit of an overstatement. I mean, I've been in training mode. But these changes are pretty sweet if they pan out how I hope they do.
Increased attack damage. Does Love Deluxe do damage when you pop it?
No, I'm just assuming that means the double hits do more damage, hopefully.
Oh, okay. You dumbass, that's what move?
That's the one where she, like, charges at you and kicks you and then grabs you with her hand. So now, when it gets blocked, she jumps back, sort of like Bao when he does his hit grab.
Oh, okay.
So now it's potentially safe. Which is pretty sweet.
So no, this is the move where it's like Kira, where she plants the bomb, right?
Yeah, this is hair bomb.
And they made it faster, made it longer. Cool.
They made it, yeah, they just made it better. There were combos where just this, you could just barely not get it into a combo, but increasing the speed means she could have more combo rounds now, which is pretty sweet.
And this is the follow-up, and they fix IPS on it, I guess.
Right.
What move is this?
Let me see. This is the counter, so it... From what I'm reading into this, is that, When you countered somebody, they were jumping in on you, they would just fall to the ground on a hard knockdown, and you couldn't combo without a taunt pre-stand. But now it sounds like you can combo after it from an anti-air counter without having to use your taunt.
I thought that was already a thing, but I guess not. I saw a combo really early in where she could get a touch of death off of any air counter.
No, you have to use your taunt to pick up from it.
Oh, okay. Cool. Could she do it with, like, a regular taunt? And did she have one of those 6-second taunts that got removed?
No, she can, she can do her own taunt restands with 2-2-X.
Yo, go away. I'm not gonna lie. No. Leave.
I'll go.
So, I'll drag you in. I don't know the names of any of these moves.
Oh, this is 2-2-X, the one that looks like a little bit isn't real, where she pokes her air into the ground and pokes up from the...
Oh, the assist, the right?
Yeah, the assist.
So this actually changes the assist also, like, yeah, it gives it more hits. Okay, cool. Using combo and scrambles. So it sounds like they really wanted this character to have more consistent routes, right?
Yeah, I don't know exactly how this will change things before, like, I don't know, I would have to actually get in there and test stuff, but it sounds like it might be able to get more combos after the
okay.
game, which is
so cool. Stan Light, how slow her lights were made me mad as fuck. I saw that in training mode, just to see what the character's moves are, and it made me so mad I just didn't want to play her.
Yeah, all of her normals really are just... fucking agonizingly slow.
Especially like when you compare her to like Cuck.
Which is not good whatsoever.
Stan Light is faster. Stan Heavy is like the long hair move, right?
Her longest one is medium.
Oh yeah, okay. Yeah. Stan Heavy is faster recovery. Crouch Light has more range. That one is super slow, right? Like,
Crouching
that's the
light is so bad. They needed to make it faster, really, but I guess you take what you can get.
But at least she has a mash option now, right?
Yeah, at least she can 5-L, hopefully.
And Crouch Heavy.
This change is really interesting. I don't know what it means. They change her sweep and just say change the damage reaction. This could mean like so many things. Like maybe it pulls them in towards you now, maybe it crumples, I don't know.
No idea. But they must have sped it, like slowed it down for a reason.
Yeah, they made it slow, so it has to do something now. They have to have had a reason to do that.
And then this is HHA, right?
No, this is 3H. This is, it's kind of an anti-air, and they made it faster now, so it's even better as an anti-air now. It has, like, upper body invincibility, so this is actually is pretty cool.
Oh, okay. That's pretty sweet. Kosaku. Okay,
like, she has, like, some pretty cool changes that could actually make her playable. Like, nothing to, like, make her shoot up in the tier list or anything, but...
Huh? I don't know. Functioning might be like a good place to start. I was talking to Gunso in the Japanese Discord one time about this character because he was talking about how he was trying to learn Yukako, and he's like, no, this character's not worth it. Character's worse than Iggy, dog tier.
She genuinely feels terrible to play. She's so slow.
Kosaku's 3M, now the stand doesn't go past the opponent when it's at a wall. Mm-hmm. And then GHA combo correction, that sounds like... Did he have a unique GHA against Josuke?
I have no clue, but apparently they did.
Okay, Giorno, Mudas have the IPS change.
They I think they made it so you can't do the crazy combos after GHHA now.
Gunblaze says that doing the GHA on Josuke didn't scale right for some reason. Just like one of those random Kuso changes that needed to go.
Yeah, it sounds about right.
His forward step is now invincible. Mad random that it wasn't to begin with. Which move is I've got you?
It says special attack.
I don't know. I don't know what that is, but it's just a generic IPS change. Bruno really got nothing. Narancia.
Narancia is so nice. You have no idea how happy this makes me. Just randomly, like after an SG, like if you're in stand on and you SG with Narancia, you try that 5L, you just no bullets shoot.
I've seen that happen when playing against you, and I'm like, what the heck is this? What is happening? Why did that happen?
He just randomly doesn't shoot when you do 5L sometimes, but they fix it, which is amazing.
That's pretty cool.
I didn't actually expect him to fix it.
I don't have a lot of faith in these developers, do you? But, you know, the stuff I've read so far is pretty good.
Yeah. It's better. Like, the patch is better than I expected it to be honest.
Mista, I saw in SDRC that this character got randomly nerfed, but this doesn't really look like randomly nerfs unless these moves have something that I don't know about, and I don't know a lot about Mista.
Yeah, the SPK Sunpunk was being super doomer about the changes, but I genuinely have no clue.
What does this imply?
Yeah, I have no clue.
I don't know. People are being doomer about it, but I don't know what it means, so moving on. This is the end. This is the one where he's like, Totemija! But, I guess that whiffs when they're against a wall. Stand will make an attack based on direction the user is facing at the time of activation. When in close contact with opponent, stand will make an attack in an unintended direction. Okay, quality of life change. Those niche corner confirms that drop. Cool.
Trish got some stuff.
This character is doo-doo, so cool.
Nothing to really make her good, but they gave her some things.
Corrected timing. I guess that makes 2H you can quick stand on more. Stand heavy. Increased mana blow off an opponent is airborne and hit. That's actually pretty good because her combos are just, like, fairly inconsistent. Stand normal, crouch heavy. Cool. Awesome. Maybe she'll be able to get damage. Like, all scrambles more consistently. Made her jump H bigger. I don't know what move this is. Is that rush punches?
I have no clue. I have not touched this character a single time.
Oh, Gunblaze says that 2H can't QSO anymore. That's weird. And then Spice Girl is... I know what her moves are, but I don't know what the names are.
Is that Super? Because she had a kind of a glitchy Super.
Didn't she? What was glitchy? Oh! What do you mean?
Like, the last hit would just whiff and you would just get punished because the Super would just not do the last hit.
Okay, Gunblaze is correcting himself. He says that previously Trish could QSO during startup of her 2H and now she can't. Okay, that's fair. Gachio didn't get anything, which is, like, fine. I feel like he's still in the point where people don't really know the matchup.
Yeah, this is definitely one of those characters that if you don't know how to defend against, he's just going to loop you forever.
For real. But they made his wake up consistent, which was annoying, because when I was playing against Splash in OTG2, I forgot that I had to delay the 214Ls longer than against other characters. Because against Hermes and Gonshio and Ice, if you don't delay the ball set, SG is a consistent answer to the setup.
Glad that that's gone.
For real. Prosciutto, how's this? Adjusted the hitbox, slipping behind the opponent and not hit under. I don't know which move how this is. Even with aging level 2 or higher, jump seal state, you could effectively perform jump behaviors. It's been corrected so that he's restricted. You can't super jump while you're cursed anymore, which, that's fine.
3H is, how's this, is the overhead in standard.
Okay, well this doesn't look like it really got changed at all.
Yeah, he didn't really get anything.
Cool, that's fine. Well, I mean, you can't super jump while you're cursed anymore.
They fixed that. I didn't even know that was a thing. That would have been nice to know.
So, this is one of the changes that I read, like one of the ones that I skimmed to at work because I wanted to see if this character got gutted. And he basically got no changes, except some... He got minor damage nerfs because now you can't do more than 1-2-1-4 in a combo. And I think that's a really healthy change because, you know, what people want nerfed is Metallica, right? The T-pose.
Right.
But that's like the coolest thing this character has. It's one of the most unique moves I've ever seen in a fighting game. If you make that move worse, you're hurting the identity of the character. So if he gets the guaranteed damage from Metallica, but he gets less damage in other places, and now he also can't do, like, resets, like, through the system changes, I think those are healthy changes for the character while maintaining what makes him cool.
I think I can agree with that. Like, there's a lot of stuff that he has too much stuff that he can abuse right now. Like, he just has too many things that are good.
I think the biggest problem is that the debuff lasts too long after GHA.
He has like fucking 18 seconds or something.
Yeah, you get 3 Metallicas. It's really fucked up.
It's absolutely absurd.
But that's cool changes for him. He got hurt by system changes, and they nerfed him in a way that, you know, he gets less damage from combos, but he gets guaranteed damage from Metallica. That's cool. Interesting change for the character. Probably could have done more, but I like it.
I think they should make the radius smaller, personally.
Oh, yeah.
But, yeah.
So you can't do it, like, on the whole stage, basically.
Yeah, it basically covers the whole stage, depending on where you're standing.
Jolene's You're the Enemy is,
I think that's
sort Kicks, of right?
Buddha's.
Yeah. And I Made It, is that flips?
That's the where she, like, flips over you and shoots you.
That move is annoying, dude.
It's obnoxious.
But that's cool. I didn't see Foo Fighters doing it that many times in a combo. I saw Honk busting a nut over Johnny changes in the chat.
Yeah, I haven't actually read these.
Okay. Unmounted stand heavy. You get to move forward, which is cool because he doesn't get to move anyway. Horse stand medium. Fixed amount of hit stop, increased distance. Cool. Combos are more consistent. Where's the upper half? What is that?
I think that's his teleport?
Sped of behavior, completely invincible. Yeah, he was. Wait.
So, the Johnny players were kind of freaking out about this because they think it might mean he's not invincible during it anymore.
O2Con says it's definitely teleport. Adjusted effect player, completely invincible. Let's make the hit less likely. Well.
It's just another one of those weird
I don't know what this really means. It looks like he's not invincible. I can make it is the 4 and 6 8, it's like the movement tool unmounted, right?
Yeah, that's right.
Corrected activation priority command skills, which means that this, I guess this has priority over quarter circle forward, which is nails. But that's cool. I like that change.
Wait, yeah, that's right. It's tackle.
Oh, this is tackle?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Let me turn this music down. It's kind of loud. Adjust the distance from the opponent when guarded. Does that mean that it's safe in more circumstances now?
I would assume so, since they said it made it easier to use the trampolines.
Okay. Send me down the hole. Changed command of it. Changed, I'll call it Tusk. That's the nails and command send me down the hole. Okay, so now he has fewer overlapping commands. That's cool. Mm-hmm. You get to regen your nails by pressing down S, no. The hole will attack you, decrease recovery, sped up the... This character has so many changes, dude. The hole will attack you is the guard crush hole that tracks.
I believe so, yeah.
And then they made it faster and they gave it less recovery. I don't know, that was already like his best move. I've got to get there is 6-8, change that it transitions to hit when guarded, change to be cancelable, spy special moves. That's cool, and he gets combos off of his already invincible move. He's gonna do like 6-8 into DP just for to like have 40 frames of invincibility or something.
Yeah. I mean, he needs it. Dude can't do shit on the ground.
He was a little too crippled on the ground. I've got to get their back. Okay, same thing. Back is special, cancelable. This was the first character that I looked at, and he got, like, phenomenal changes.
Yeah, I saw the 2M change, and I'm crying.
So, the reason why I never bother for Golden Spin, other than getting it from HHA or GHA or Corpse Parts, is because... It just drains on its own too fast. Your spin gauge gets used when you use any moves with steel balls, but even if you don't use them, it just passively drains way too fast. You have to do 2-2M every so often in your pressure to like put the timer on spin cooldown, like reset. User mode, stand medium. This is one of the worst normals in the game. The previous patch, this shit is fucking terrible. It had way too much pushback, and it had, like, not... It just had way too much pushback. It made your block strings drop. It made your combos drop. It just wasn't good for anything. You basically, playing gyro, had to avoid using this normal as much as humanly possible to make anything work. But they made it move forward, which makes it seem like you can actually use it now. But they also increase the knockback.
Instead of blow up, or whatever the fuck they were saying before. It's weird.
I really don't know. Maybe it means pushback. I don't know. But if they made it move forward, that means that 5H isn't going to drop after it anymore, which is cool. You can't. You can now use this for anything. Stand heavy attack, increased forward distance when you use it, and increased knockback, and they made it more active. I don't know what making it more active is for. But making it move forward is cool because it's a small normal, and you could only do like two lights before your combos and block strength started dropping just because it was so small.
Yeah, like, I'm always seeing you talk about how hard or specific his combos are, and if these changes like kind of normalize his routes, then I think that's a pretty great change.
What makes them really specific is the amount of delays and routes you have to use on specific characters once you've launched them. Like, if you do 2H and you want to throw 2 steel balls at them, the delay is different from, like, every fucking character. It's really annoying. But this is cool. This means you actually get to do pressure because this moves forward and 5M moves forward. That was his biggest problem, is that his pressure was pretty bad if you didn't have balls set already. Crouch medium. They made it more active. I don't know why the fuck they did that. This was like the best 2 in the game already.
It's already an insane normal.
Change to make it easier to use in scrambles. I mash already... this shit all the time. I mash it constantly. Because you get the fucked up Oki from it. I don't know why they made this normal better, but... You know, awesome. I guess this means you get to be plus on it now or something if you do it from a block string, which is, you know, that's fucked up.
Sick.
Crouch heavy made it faster, but it still has a bad hitbox, so, you know, might be a more reliable anti-air because it kind of low profiles a little bit. Kala asks what the 2M active frames might adjust. So... What that means, I think, is that, I know Makoto, Will and Gyro got a laundry list of buffs, and I wasn't expecting that for either of them because they're already good characters.
They saw your loss CC, and they were like, we need to amend this travesty immediately.
Kala asks what the 2M change actually means. So, this means that you can now... probably more reliably meaty with 2M and have it be plus. It's a minus 2 normal, and if you have more active frames, if you meaty with it, you're going to be plus. Crouch heavy attack, already went over that. Jump heavy attack. They made the hitbox bigger. Cool. I don't really know what that means. Maybe it gives him better, like, pokes from the air. Mounted crouch heavy. I like that they did this because there was way too many circumstances where you had to sacrifice damage to get the mounted 2H launch. Are you okay? Are you going through a tunnel?
Oh, is my mic doing something?
It was like... But,
oh, my bad.
Okay, yeah. So crouch heavy, you move forward while you use it, which is cool. Awesome. This probably also makes being able to follow up from it easier because you move forward. What you do is, if the opponent is particularly close to you, you use 2H as a launcher and you're able to dash with the horse and do 5MH into steel balls or whatever ender you want at that point. But previously it was only when the opponent was particularly close to you that you could use that as a follow-up. And Run Wild is the horse DP. And it says extended final hit stop. Which I guess means it launches them longer. Maybe you can get HHA off it or something now.
Was that the one where he, like, stomps around?
No, it's the one where he charges at you and he has armor.
Oh, okay.
Valentine, I'll dispose of you. That's the gun. It has IPS change, but it already had that. I don't know why they put that here. Hiding in the next dimension is Flag. It has normal IPS, and you could actually do something with that, but the combos where you could do that weren't practical. Gift from the other side, I think that is the fireball, the DP, or the dive kick, right?
Let me see. Yeah, that's the clone dive kick.
Okay, that shit needed more recovery. It was kind of insane.
Yeah, that move is fucking obnoxious.
It, you get full combo off of it, and it comes at an angle where you can't really jump over it unless you're already close. But they gave him more damage, which, cool. I don't like when they just strictly nerf moves. They fix Gappy's GHA buff, or GHA bug, weather report, Poochie, Cape Canaveral, gallery items, I guess for those characters, and then the other stuff for them. Cool. Yeah, I think that's it. From what I can tell, it's pretty much strictly good changes. There's nothing here that I see where I'm like, yo, what is this whack shit?
Very light. They're very light on nerfs. I don't think any character really got any substantial nerf.
I'm trying to think of what the IPS changes and the unblockable protection now is. I saw somebody in SGRC say there's some kind of left-right protection now too, but I didn't see that anywhere.
Interesting.
I don't know where they got that, and I just spent an hour reading the patch notes and didn't see anything about it. So I guess
there's already kind of left-right protection.
Have you run into circumstances where that's relevant?
Yeah, like, if sometimes if they hit from, like, forward, and they do, like, an assist, like a punch rush assist, like, you could just keep holding back even though they're on the other side, and it'll keep blocking.
I wanted them to get rid of those stupid-looking cross-ups where the jump-in hits same side, but you phase through the opponent.
those interactions are super fucked up.
But anyway, I think these changes are good. I'm eating like a bandit because pretty much every single character that I play got buffed.
Literally just two of the characters that got substantial changes you play, which is kind of nice.
Yeah, Will and Gyro both got a lot, but who do you think got the most? Iggy, Yukako?
I think potentially Yukako. Like, there's just a lot of things she had that just didn't really work, or just felt really bad, or just the combos just didn't work out because of how slow things were. But depending on how these actually feel in game, she might be an actual playable character now.
Cool. That's awesome. They nerfed Risotto in a healthy way. Wish they would have nerfed Kakuin a little bit more. Wish they... there are some characters that are just frustrating to play against and not in like a... You know, no, I'm gonna hold it right there before I start getting put on scrub codes, but... Iggy and Old Joseph, Yukako, Trish, they all got good stuff, but... Like Kala said in the chat, Iggy having normal dash jump is pretty significant. It's going to make his combos a lot more consistent. Along with the other changes that he got with like his stand 5H and his stand 2M. Stand 2M buffs are really interesting.
Did he have like his really slow jump squat when he did his dash jump before? Is that what the change is?
No, the dash jump change refers to the fact that Iggy had to run forward a certain distance before he could dash jump, unlike other characters.
Yeah, that sounds terrible.
Bottom tiers, for the most part, got buffed, I think.
Yeah, the buffs for the bottom characters are pretty nice, but they're not really going to propel them like above bottom. I think they're still gonna be on the bottom, but I mean, they're nice changes, I guess.
This game is still in a point where it's fairly new, and there's still a lot. If we were playing the first patch, right, there would still be a lot of stuff to explore. Like, the meta would be shifting. I'm not expecting huge sweeping changes for every character. It's too early for that.
I agree, yeah. I'm not too surprised about them, like, leaving the super good characters like they are.
Yeah, it's like,
but
we're not...
Yeah.
I don't think anybody's playing the matchups for those characters as good as they could be.
Still think it's kind of fucked up. My character's the only one that's gotten, like, a huge nerf. Everybody else is just kind of skate-free.
Is that true?
Fucked up Vortex.
Aren't there other characters who got bodied?
Like,
They're a bit nervous.
Prosciutto got hit pretty fucking hard.
Yeah, that's true.
But anyway, I'm gonna enjoy the rest of my night. Anybody that wants to know further thoughts about what I think on these changes can message me on Twitter or in Discord. Peace and out for the night. I might stream some games later. Probably not, but I might. Thanks, gfelt, for going over these notes with me.
Yeah, no problem.
And we'll see you next time.